Hello students, today we are going to study here chapter 2 of SST and chapter name is Northern Mountains. As you know students, in previous chapter we already discussed about physical division of India, and the Northern Mountain of India is also in physical division. So let us discuss about the chapter the Northern Mountains. And in this chapter main learning objects are to locate the Northern Mountain on the map of India and to identify the ranges Himadri, Himachal and Shivalik. And third point is to state the importance of Himalayas. And students, the Himalayas formed by the three hills, Himalayas, Karakoram and Purvanchal Mountain. So first topic is the Himalayas. The Himalayas range covers the north and northeastern border of India. It is stretched in long curve from Jammu and Kashmir in north to Arunachal Pradesh in the east. And Himalayas form boundary between India and China. In this state, Jammu and Kashmir lies in the Himalayas range. The highest peak in the world, the Mount Everest, lies in this range. Students, as you can see in this map, Himalayas range. The Himalayas range covers the north and northeastern border of India. It is a stretch in long curve from Jammu and Kashmir in the north and Arunachal Pradesh in the east. Himalayas form boundary between India and China. The state of Jammu and Kashmir lies in the Himalayan range, and highest peak in the world, the Mount Everest, lies in this range. So this is the Himalayan range. In this northern mountain, second range is Karakoram range. To the northwest of Himalayas lies the Karakoram range. It is located on the river Indus, K2, also known as Mount Godwin Austen. The second highest peak in the world lies in this range. Next, third topic is Purvanchal Hill Ranges. The Purvanchal Hill lies on the northeastern side of India. They include the Garo, Jhansia, Naga and Mizo hills. These hills are not very high and are covered with thick forest. Purvanchal hills include the states of Assam, Nagaland, Mizoram, Tripura, Meghalaya and Manipur. Students, in this chapter, next point is important rivers of the northern mountains. So, important rivers of northern mountains are the Indus, Satluj, Ganga, Yamuna, Brahmaputra, and Saraswati. The main ranges of Himalayas, the Greater Himalayas or Himadri, the Middle Himalayas or Himachal, the Outer Himalayas or Shivalik. These are the main ranges of Himalayas. So Let us discuss our first range, the Greater Himalayas or Himadri. In this range, the Greater Himalayas or Himadri is the northernmost and highest range of the Himalayas. Its peaks are covered with snow throughout the year. Kanchenjunga and Annapurna are two of the highest mountain peak of the Greater Himalayas. Kanchenjunga is the highest peak in India. There are a number of glaciers in this region. These glaciers travel down the mountain slopes. When they reach warmer areas, they start melting and form rivers. The two major glaciers of these mountains are the Gangotri and Yamunotri. An important pass in this range is Jojila Pass in Jammu Kashmir state. This region is very cold and therefore scarcely populated. So this is the Himadri range of Himalayas. Our second range, the Middle Himalayas or Himachal. Second topic is the Middle Himalayas or Himachal. Between the Himadri and the Shivalik range lies the Himachal or the Middle Himalayas. These mountains are not as high as the Himadri. Beautiful valleys such as Kashmir Valley, Kullu Valley and the Kangra Valley are located here. Hill towns like Shimla, Manali and Dalhousie are also found in this region. The Himachal range is covered with thick forest of trees like pine, oak. Winters are cold while summers are pleasant and the climate is good for cultivation. Fruit orchard and tree gardens on the lower slopes of the Himachal range can be seen here. The third topic is the Outer Himalayas or Shivalik. In this range, the southernmost and the lowest range of the Himalayas is known as the Outer Himalayas or Shivalik. These are very low ranges. They are covered with thick forest and wildlife. And in this map, as you can see, yellow color is represent the Shivalik range. And next topic is life in the northern mountains. In this region, life in the Greater Himalayas is tough. People experience severe cold in winters since the land is rocky. It is difficult to grow many crops. And houseboats are common in Kashmir, in Uttarakhand. Many religious centers like the Gangotri, Yamunotri, Kedarnath, Badrinath and Hemkund Sahib. In this Himachal, Shivalik and Purvanchal region, farming is the main occupation. The practice terrace farming and grow rice, barley, maize and potato. Sheep rearing is common here. People also engage in wood carving and shawl weaving. Darjeeling in West Bengal is the famous hill station located to the south of Sikkim. It is famous for its tea gardens and high quality tea. The government has protected and reserved forest areas in the Himalayas to safeguard forest and animal life. Some of the well-known reserved forest and national parks are Jim Corbett National Park in the Uttarakhand and the Kaziranga National Park in Assam. And last topic of this chapter, importance of the northern mountains. The Himalayas mountain protect India from the cold winds coming from the Central Asia. They also act as a barrier from the rain bearing monsoon winds and prevent from them leaving India, resulting in plenty of rainfall in the northern part of country. Rich wildlife is also found in this region. Many animals such as snow leopard, tiger, rhinoceros and wild yak are found here. The Himalayan forests are a great source of valuable forest products like timber, medicines, resin and honey. Hello students, as we already discussed in second chapter, the northern mountains in physical division of India, and in this activity we will discuss about rivers of India, especially the Himalayan river system. Activity is mark the rivers of Himalayan region on the physical map of India. So let us begin our topic. In this system, three main rivers included: Indus, Ganga and Brahmaputra. So as you can see in this map, first is Indus rivers. This blue line represent Indus rivers. It's originate from China near the Mansarovar Lake. Indus river flows through the Ladakh district of Jammu and Kashmir and subsequently river gets into Pakistan. Next is Ganga. Ganga is a transboundary river of Asia which flows through India and Bangladesh. The 2525 km river rises in the western Himalayas in the Indian state of Uttarakhand and flows south and east through the Gangetic plain of river India and Bangladesh. Third is Brahmaputra river. Brahmaputra is a 2390 miles long river that flows with the boundaries of three countries in Asia: China, India and Bangladesh. And students, these red circle represent the Indus river, Ganga river and Brahmaputra river. So now students, you have to take one physical map of India and mark these rivers on map and paste in your notebook as an activity. I hope you understand this activity.